Let's see if we can just somehow slowly get her off. That's okay, Mama.
This is a little bit of a precarious position right here because I'm not exactly sure what I'm supposed to do. Oh my God. Okay, well, we're gonna go for it. Oh,
good morning, everybody, and welcome to another beautiful day. I hope the start of your day is absolutely incredible. We actually have to do a little maintenance on Lucy's cage here in a minute, but first I'm gonna go over and check and see if we have any snake eggs upstairs and downstairs. And like I mentioned yesterday, we don't have a tremendous amount of colubrids that are gonna still be laying eggs over the next little bit, you know, maybe 15, 20 at the very most, but a lot of them aren't quite ready, so we might have a gap. I'm still gonna check all of them, just see. This girl's not even in her box. It tells you that obviously she isn't gonna go, and you can see some of the dates are a little bit later, so we know those aren't going to go. This girl is out of her box. This girl's not due to lay. These girls aren't due to lay here. Not due to lay here. Not too many prospects for eggs today when it comes to colubrids, but I did have a few ball pythons that looked like they were going to pop anytime. So I'm just going to check one or two more boxes here to see. Nope, girl's out of her box. Definitely is. That's it for colubrids. So no colubrid eggs today, guys. But like I mentioned, there are a bunch of ball pythons there. Dude, take a look at this monkey right here. That is actually a VPI Axanthic. She's about ready to explode. We have an albino ball python here that's about ready to explode. We have a ton of animals that are just exploding at the seam, ready to pop anytime. I mean, take a look at this chocolate pinstripe right here. Woohoo! Man, she looks uncomfortable. I'm just gonna go ahead and check to see if we have any eggs in here. And with any luck, we'll have a clutch or two and then we'll pull the egg. And sure enough, we had a couple clutches, starting with this one right here, which is actually just an Enchi ball python, but she was bred to a super Enchi lemon blast, which means there's pastels. All should be Enchi. Most of them are gonna be super Enchi because it's bred to an Enchi, and then there'll be like pinstripes and pastels and all kinds of other stuff. Regardless, looks like she's on a really nice clutch of eggs here. So let's see if we can just somehow slowly get her off. That's okay, Mama. Oh, it's always harder when you're doing it alone. It doesn't help when you got a camera in your hand too, that's for sure. So I'm just gonna go ahead. These eggs are all over the place, which means I'm gonna have to candle them for sure. Mama did give me a little nip. That's okay. You're okay, sweetheart. But the eggs look really good. Again, we're gonna candle these guys. We'll just set them right in here and then go ahead and pull these guys out. Once we get them all set up, we'll take them into a dark room and we'll candle them. I've showed you guys candling a few times, and basically what it is you just go into a dark room and you take a light, you shine it into the egg, you look for the embryo and network of veins in it, and you make sure it's right side up. No big deal. Regardless, we got 2, 4, 6, 8 good eggs. That is a really good clutch for this girl. Oh, and one slugger just to go along with it. Now, what's interesting is there's a little discoloration here on this egg. That's not unusual at all, and that's nothing to worry about. I mean, 99% of the time, eggs that have a little discoloration for whatever reason still will hatch fine. So we'll go ahead, candle these eggs up. We'll move on to the next clutch. Next up, we have a feisty little monkey right here. You could tell she wants to bite me. It's okay, Mom. It's weird, she's not really coiled around her eggs much, and the eggs are nice and small, which means there's usually a bunch of them there. There are a couple sluggers. She happens to be a het caramel that is bred to a spider het caramel, so we could produce some spider caramels and stuff like that. But again, these eggs are nice and small, which is kind of good because usually means that there's quite a few of them. And again, Mom is not happy at all. I'm trying to just gently take her eggs without her getting too upset. I'm gonna just go ahead, pull these over here, get these in the box. You can tell just by the softness of these eggs, these are really fresh, like she just finished laying probably within the last hour or so. And that's probably why she wasn't coiled around and protect him as much, but she's definitely probably wore out. We'll make sure we get her cage cleaned up, get her all set. She did have 3 little sluggers, but she had 2, 4, 6 good eggs, which isn't too bad. Again, that's a recessive mutation caramel. So in theory, 1 in 4 on average are gonna be caramels, and then 1 in 6 would be a spider caramel on average. But again, those are averages over thousands and thousands or hundreds of thousands of eggs called Mendelian genetics. So when you have 6 eggs, you could get a bunch of caramels and a bunch of caramel spiders, or you can get no caramels and no caramel spiders. That's just how genetics work. So it's kind of the luck of the draw. But over time, the averages always work out to be what the averages are in Mendelian genetics. And that's it for eggs for today over at BHB. Let's go ahead and tackle Lucy. Lucy's definitely getting a lot better, but I do have to get her out in order to clean her cage up, because we really haven't moved her out to do a real thorough cage cleaning in probably about a month or so, because she was gravid, and then right afterwards we didn't want to really mess her around too much. So now it's time to go in there and get her out and see if she's going to be in a little bit better mood.
Come on out, that's easy. You come right on out, sweetheart.
This is a little bit of a precarious position right here because I'm not exactly sure what I'm supposed to do. Oh my God. Okay, well, we're gonna go for it. Hang on, watch out. Yeah. Whew, that was scary. There you go, girl. Okay, she's all right. She's all right. Okay, so that didn't go that bad.
Oh, jeez.
I tell you what, there was definitely a couple spots where a week ago she would have bit me, 100%.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so she's calming down. This is all good news. Now we got out, we can do a real good cage clean, get her back in. Oh, my God. That got my heart rate up because I don't think I've ever been in a worse position where she's just sitting by my leg.
Oh,
Lucy, I love her. All cleaned up, just got to get Lucy back in again. She's acting really good compared to what she was, so... That being said, she's in a pretty precarious spot right here. See, she would have bit me a week ago like that. I mean, you know, 100% she would have bit me. Just be careful. Hang on, just let me spin around. Oh. Hang on. Let me set it down. Alright, there she goes. There she is. She's alright. Just maneuvering her around a little bit. That's about it. And that's, again, a couple little precarious spots, but to be honest with you, a week ago she would have crushed me. She has really gotten back to her old Lucy ways. Not even one strike in that entire event. Yeah, she did get close. She was definitely going to strike a couple times, but again, she's definitely restrained herself back to the more normal Lucy. Looking amazing. She's going to get a couple rabbits this week, and we should be good to go. I couldn't be more excited because tomorrow starts the new era in the vlog. And what I mean by that is Jay starts tomorrow, so he's going to be helping with filming and editing and just be another person so that I can free up my time not only to do a better job of vlogging and be even a better storyteller and bring you guys on more amazing journeys, but also I think the vlog is just gonna look a lot prettier. Like I mentioned in the past, we listened to what you guys said and I think that we have a really good thing where you're gonna get the same amount of this, but you're gonna get a lot of extra stuff. It's gonna be really cool to not only verbally tell a story, but also visually tell an amazing story. In my mind, when I'm collecting python eggs, it's gonna go something like this. But truthfully, guys, it's not going to be like that. The vlog's not going to change that terribly much, but it's going to give me an opportunity to tell the story of the day a little bit better, be able to get other people from the crew involved more, like Lori and Noah and Eric and Jessica and Kelsey and everybody. It's going to give us an opportunity to be even a better, more kind of robust vlog. Plus, we're going to be able to do travel adventure stuff because you got to remember, in the past, the biggest part about travel that was hard was I had to vlog, edit, travel, do everything myself. Now to have a second person involved, it's gonna really open up the opportunity for some amazing things, but we definitely need your help. We need you to continue to be engaged with us. Tell us what you think, what you don't like, what you'd like to see more of, because I wanna take this to the next level. I wanna be the best possible vlog that we possibly can. So tomorrow starts the new era.
That's right, guys, I'm back. It's Jay Tomsky. For those of you who don't know, I'm here hanging out at the Reptarium. I'm gonna be taking over a lot of camera work and editing for Brian, our favorite YouTuber. We have a lot of stuff planned for the future, so let's get it started.
And like I mentioned, we're really excited about the future, but we need your help. You know, right now, you know, go down in the comments, let me know what you'd like to see in the future that we might do. Give us some ideas. And again, keep telling us how you're liking the progression of this. Like I had mentioned, I am super excited for the future.
I'm not only a camera guy and editor, I'm actually an animal lover. And to be honest with you guys, I've actually watched every single one of Brian's vlogs. So it's not like I don't know what goes on here and I just want to be a part of this project. You know, it's really special to me to be able to help out not only with Brian, but to help animal education as a whole. Like you said before, we have a lot of stuff planned for the future. And if you want to see some behind the scenes stuff, follow me at Instagram at jaytomsky.
I want to take a second, guys, because this is really important. I realize it's going to be a little bit more boring, but hang in there. I really want you to listen to me because it's an incredibly important topic. You know, a lot of our love for reptiles or animals in general kind of started that one day when the people brought animals into our school when we were in elementary. Well, you know, the animal rights and kind of the people that want to outlaw all this stuff that we've got going on are always trying to attack the ability to educate people or even get animals in people, and certainly the ownership, not just of reptiles, but of all kinds of animals. Well, they do it in two ways. First, what they'll do is they'll try to attack a national law, and if that doesn't work, they go state by state. Right now, kind of both things are happening, and let me explain. There's actually a bill that is being brought to the House of Representatives, H.R. 2863, and basically what it does is it outlaws all animal traveling shows, including animal education shows to schools. Yes, that's right. We're not talking about elephants and tigers, because I get why people have an issue with that. You know, not that I want to get into that, not that I personally have a problem as long as the animals are cared for, but the fact is that this bill would actually outlaw us taking animals to schools and educating kids. That's right, if you remember that day when someone came in and educated you and had that Burmese python or whatever, that would be outlawed if this bill passed. On top of that, there's, I think, 5 states that already have introduced legislation that is going to eventually go to vote that is doing it on a statewide level. Now, it's a lot easier to pass a state law than it is a federal law, right? So this is something that we have to be aware of because they are trying to outlaw educational shows. Now, listen, people come here to the Reptarium and that would still be okay, but the fact is a bigger part of what we do at the Reptarium is going on site to schools and libraries and even birthday parties and educating people about animals. If this bill were to pass on a state level or on a federal level, we couldn't do that anymore. None of the animals in here could leave this place to go educate people. Now, what do we do about it? I'm not 100% sure. The first thing I want to ask you to do is to go to usarc.org. I'm going to put a link in the description. Go show them some love. Go show them some support because as a reptile keeper, they are protecting our rights to keep reptiles. So go show them some love, number one, and they'll keep us posted on what they want to do. There's probably going to be times where they're going to want us to send in letters, maybe calls, whatever the case may be. That's the first thing we need to do. Other than that, we just need to band together because, again, I'm just saying that this is a slippery slope, people. I mean, they outlaw that. Next thing you know, none of us are going to be able to keep animals. So, again, I know this was a boring part. Sorry to break from our normal routine, but this is so important to me. I don't want the ability for me to go educate people to be taken away, and I don't want anyone else's ability to be taken away either. So, please, go show USARC some love and comment down below what you think about this and what you think we can do about this.
Just like yesterday, more baby geckos hatching. Holy moly, are we gonna have a lot of little baby leopard geckos this year. I love it though, I love little babies. They are so absolutely adorable. Take a look at this white and yellow Tremper albino right here. Oh my God, that thing is absolutely stunning. And that's the thing, I mean, with the variety that we produce and then the quantity we produce, we definitely have a lot of stuff coming up. So every day when we're hatching 100, 200 geckos, it's just so cool to see what's hatching out. Take a look at this thing here. That's just basically like almost a pure white animal. But that is actually a Super Snow Tremper white and yellow. Oh my God, that thing is adorable. And of course, we just have this bold pattern right here, which is a polygenic trait bred for that striping. And then this is actually a bold bell, which is the Bell Line albino with that polygenic bold stripe. I'll have to do a big gecko show here pretty soon. With that said, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end the vlog. I really do wanna know what you guys think we should do about that potential legislation. It's certainly something that we have to act on. We can't sit back because animal education shows are kind of the foundation of people's love of animals. So let me know your thoughts down in the comments. As for now, have an amazing day. I love you guys so much. Be kind to someone, and I promise I'm going to see you guys tomorrow.